Welcome to the 2020 Minneapolis College of Art and Design Master of Fine Arts Open Studio Virtual Tour. I'm Bo-Young Ann, and I will be your narrator. This is a 360-degree video. You are able to independently move your perspective by dragging your finger or cursor across the video. Welcome to Bo-Young Ann's studio. Feel free to check out the various projects that she is working on. There is the ongoing digitally illustrated children's book of Korean folktales she grew up listening to on the iPad, two in-progress paintings on the wall, few prints from the series of screen-printed pipe-smoking tigers, an icon in Korean culture, with added line work that was developed by Bo in 2013. And last but not least, an embroidery project of the same tiger that makes an appearance in three of her four works. Have fun, enjoy, be kind, and stay safe! Welcome to Lucas Carson's studio space. Believe it or not, he cleaned it up just for this. As you can probably see, he loves working with the figure. Lately, Lucas has been interested in the relationship between the canvas and the maker, and how his body can be presented on the canvas non-representationally. Kaylee Burcham's practice is the joining of graphic design and everyday interactions between visuals and people to enhance their lives. She achieves this through applying empathetic design throughout personal and client-based commissions, as well as creating compelling educational experiences in forms of public design works. Kaylee's works serve as a mode of communication whose purpose is not only to visually provoke thought, but also as a way to articulate complicated situations and provide a method of documentation. Alejandro Junyao Zhang is a Chinese interdisciplinary artist. His studio is basically a storage room for performance props, character costumes, and audio-visual equipment for installation. Maylin Kopecky currently lives in Plymouth, Minnesota. She specializes in highly detailed, hyper-realistic drawings and paintings. After developing multiple sclerosis at the age of 13, diagnosed at 15, she began to use art as another form of language to express her ideas. Kopecky received a Bachelor of Fine Arts degree from the University of Minnesota, graduating with high distinction. She is currently pursuing her Master's of Fine Arts degree at the Minneapolis College of Art and Design. Kopecky was a grant recipient at the Metropolitan Regional Arts Council Next Step Fund in 2019 and was awarded the MFA Trustee Scholarship at MCAD. She has received multiple awards for her work and has been an art instructor for both adults and children. She is currently a teaching assistant at Artistic Moments and MCAD. In addition to her visual arts practice, Kopecky is also a musician and has completed the MMTA Level 10 piano performance and Level 4 theory exams, passing both with distinction. She plays multiple instruments, writing compositions for solo piano and a variety of ensembles. Darren Schneibel is an interdisciplinary artist who earned a BFA from North Dakota State University in Fargo, North Dakota. Darren's studio is his laboratory. It is a workshop he uses to explore materials, technologies, and ideas. It is a space he uses to rest and focus on his work. Darren's most recent work, Mass Water, is about the feeling of being on the open ocean. Darren served in the Navy and cites his service as an important influence on his approach to creativity. The open ocean environment is never still. Constant and massive movement is unsettling at first, but soon becomes soothing. The steady pendulous rhythm persists day after day without end. Darren's thesis project, currently titled Infinite Trend, is about technology and time. It addresses how changes in technology over time separates us from each other and ourselves. He asks, does the infinite unity of existence become apparent when the appearance of time is eliminated? If temporal separation is revealed as an illusion, does everything become simultaneously present like the water in a river? Dan's work centers on creating landscape and still life paintings that at once convey movement and serenity. He is constantly challenging his own processes to develop new ways to move beyond representation toward distillation. He strives for economy in his marks and to communicate nothing more than exactly enough. Dan's work is influenced by both Impressionism and Abstract Expressionism, leading him to explore the power of color, the gravity of each mark, and the ways abstraction and representation each strengthen the other. Dan's style has progressed from a literal representation to a focus on the individuality of brushstrokes. Though oil is his preferred medium, there are times when he must work a piece to completion in one sitting. At these moments, he creates with acrylic paint because it enables him to work quickly in layers while protecting the identity of each mark. Kate Gunther is an artist, illustrator, actor, writer, and theater maker. She creates works that centers around narrative derived from personal experience and fantastical imagination. Whether performative or visual, her practice focuses around honest emotion that stirs recognition and curiosity in the viewer. Kate thinks storytelling is one of the most genuine ways we connect to one another and to the natural world. She is constantly fascinated and spurred on by the adventurers, explorers, and dreamers. The people who have sought the unknown or imagined beyond the understood. She sees potential narrative in everything around her. Kate finds beauty and intrigue in the quiet communications between two people's subtle body language, as well as in the sweeping grandeur of an operatic aria played in the back row. Kate collects and captures extraordinary stories, as well as the wonder and magic in the ordinary moments of life. Alondra Marisol Garza is an interdisciplinary artist. This is her studio where she makes, stores, and hangs her work. You can see a big painting across the sculpture hanging off the roof. On the walls, she has paintings, photos, prints, paper, and decorations. Take a look around and find some of the titles of her pieces. Welcome to her Texan-Mexican-American world. This is Alondra's installation, Borders, Barriers, Justice, from her latest work, which will be exhibited next year at Clues, a Chicano gallery in St. Paul. This installation is inspired by archives from the University of Minnesota. It is a reflection of being trapped in a border and the barriers that Chicanecs have lived throughout the years. Jordan Brennan is a painter residing in Minneapolis, Minnesota. She's originally from Wisconsin and received her BA in Studio Arts at Upper Iowa University in Fayette, Iowa. Jordan's oil paintings highlight the human condition and reflect on the internal struggles one has with the outside world. Through abstract mark making and subconscious play, her paintings represent the layers of unresolved thoughts and struggles that exist in our minds. Jocelyn Suzuka creates installations that unearth the pains of cultural abandonment and the deeply rooted narrative of generational trauma. She's concerned with finding her identity within the margins of two countries, America, the nation she calls home, and Japan, the country of her birth. Resting on the wall, the hanging scroll paintings cannot be entered without first confronting the guardians, small, tender, stuffed animals. Each animal is carefully crafted using hand-sewn techniques passed down to Suzuka as a child from her Japanese mother, as it was in her family for generations of mothers to daughters. This sewing technique is a comforting reminder of the softer parts of Suzuka's ancestral home, which she has culturally and geographically been separated from. By hand-sewing these animals, Suzuka maintains the survival of a legacy for a family that she knows only as a stranger. Hanging paintings depict yurei, ghosts, floating bodies on the periphery of life. They long for a home within paintings which contain abstract veils of suggestion, the reserved solitude of floating worlds that lie just beyond a mist. Through centering these elusive, transient non-beings within installations guarded by soft animals, Suzuka hopes to give her subjects the comfort of a protected space of their spirits to reside. Kyle Berdain is a collage artist that explores body image within gay male culture. He works in both analog and digital collage. In his recent work, Kyle has started using images of his own body, investigating what it means to navigate gay male culture in a body that is outside of the ideal body. Genre Sun is a graphic designer and illustrator. She comes from China. Her work is full of discussion and application of metaphor. Raid Ganja is a Fulbrighter from Tunisia. He is a 3D and 2D animator, and this is his studio. This place is where he finds inspiration to unleash his creativity and bring some static images to life. He spends most of his day working in his studio on different projects. His main project is a 3D short film that is consuming the majority of his time. When Raid needs to change the mood or take a break, he shifts his attention to some classic 2D animations that are also consuming a big portion of his time. But it gives him the chance to let his imagination control him and take him out of the real world for a while. Because all the fun happens inside his head, he keeps his studio very simple and minimalistic to avoid distraction. The only tools he uses to create his art are his laptop and a small graphic tablet. But the most important tool is his brain. It is the one providing him with the needed ideas.